Good morning. This is Mike Christensen with Peak One Builders. This morning I'm going to show you a couple of the advanced framing techniques that we're using in this home to help you better understand how homes are sheathed, how homes are framed to meet the new energy efficiency codes, and also just to build a better and tighter home. So I'll show you a few things here.
So years ago, most of the houses converted to building homes and doing their framing at 16 inches on center. Giving the people the idea that the homes are much better structurally built and more sound. But what we've learned over time is that by stacking framing members at 24 inches on center, which is the spacing of your trusses, we actually can reduce the amount of lumber in a building and also add extra insulation inside the building. So that's what you're seeing here. If you look, you can kind of see the vertical wall member, which is the vertical stud, is stacked directly below the truss, and the load path is straight through from the roof all the way to the foundation. Again, that allows for less lumber and more insulation. The other thing that you're going to notice here is that our headers are a little bit taller, but they're single ply. So structurally, it gives the same value, but from an insulation perspective, what you can see from the side here is that you've actually got room to put insulation inside there, which again, if you looked at things with a thermal camera years ago, you would see a big void in these areas. And so nowadays what we're doing is we're pushing that header to the outside of the building, creating a space above the window or door, and that allows us to put insulation in there. So we'll come back with an infrared camera after all the drywall's up and the house has been, had the air conditioning turned on, and we'll be able to show you what the difference is there. The windows here on this particular building are a Pella wood clad product, but this installation can be done for any type of window. And what's important to notice here is that we're using DuPont's flashing system, which when installed properly is guaranteed not to leak. And what some of the things that we'll point out here is that we use a DuPont's flex wrap product, which you can see here. And you can also see up at the top inside corner, this product reduces the bunching of flashing that typically occurred on the inside corner because it wasn't able to basically bend and wrap the corner like this new DuPont flex wrap. So we've properly installed this window. We'll show you a video on how this window is installed, and this is a certified system that we are certified to do this flashing system in this manner. So take a look at the video. So this is a typical exterior door. Manufacturers nowadays do not have flanges around their mechanical room doors. They just don't come that way. So we've got to kind of improvise a system, a flashing system, to waterproof the door as well as protect it long-term from rot. So when we walk up here, you're going to see a couple different things that we do. One of the things is we've got this metal sill pan that sits up on top of the slab and wraps all the way around. So any water that potentially could get inside the building has a flange in the back side to prevent the water from going inside the building. What you don't see is this flashing on the exterior is double wrapped. It's actually put on the jamb prior to the door installation, basically reverse installed. And then once the door is installed, we put a second layer over the top that kind of wraps around the jamb. And the last thing you're going to notice here is these jams are not wood jams. They're actually composite jams. So any long-term moisture, because it is on a gable end of a building for this particular installation, it's going to protect the jam long-term and not going to rot out at the bottom like you typically see on a wood jam. So this is basically the last step before we start applying the actual foam and lath. You can see our Tyvek stucco wrap, and you can see our quick flash products. That basically, it's the best way to seal any exterior penetration. Those go up inside the wall. You can see the size difference. So this actually sits behind the Tyvek stucco wrap and allows the water to run off the front, and the molded rubber actually will seal around the pipe itself. Again, you can kind of see how the window flashing is wrapped up underneath the underside. The Tyvek tucks up underneath the underside of the window flashing so that any water runs off. And it's lapped just like you would shingle a roof. So that's basically it. The next step will be foam and lath and the actual stucco application. So we are standing outside the bedroom that we originally filmed before the drywall and stucco was done. And we are going to show you today what the temperature is outside and inside, and also some thermal imaging to kind of let you understand how the insulation value and the techniques that were done will help show that the house is well insulated and the benefits of it. And today we're looking at a temperature outside of about 117 degrees. So we'll go inside and we'll measure the temperature inside and we'll do some thermal imaging. So this is the bedroom that we showed earlier in the framing stage and then also at insulation, showing you the importance of the advanced framing techniques that we used. And again, they kind of reiterate some of those things. The exterior studs are 2x6 placed at 24 inches on center versus a typical 16 inch on center wall assembly. And the other piece that's important here, we're gonna show through some thermal imaging, is that the headers above the windows are actually a single ply header that are typically a little bit taller than your normal box header. And that header is actually placed on the outside of the wall assembly, whereas you typically have a box header that takes up the entire wall assembly. So it'll take up a 6-inch space versus maybe like a 2-inch space that we have here. And what that does is allows you to have insulation in front of the header and just basically increases the thermal efficiency of the wall assembly. So what we're going to show you next is thermal imaging camera. And what you're going to notice is that as we pan from side to side and floor to ceiling, that the color of the wall shown through the imaging camera is very consistent color. And what that means is that the insulation value behind the wall is also very consistent. And notice that when we do go on top of the window there, you're going to notice that the color again will stay consistent. We are about 5 o'clock on probably the hottest day of the year here. It was again 117 outside, and so here we'll show you the thermal imaging. So what you want to notice is that the coloration, I'm having a hard time here getting this thing shown on the camera. But anyways, what you're noticing is that the color is going to stay consistent all the way across the top of the header. If you looked at a house that was 20 or 30 years old, you'd see a completely different color going across the top of that header. We'll pan across to this header here. And again, you can see the same thing. That color is consistent in the wall and above the window. And that's exactly what you want to see. So again, it is about 117 out today. About the hottest day of the year, and on the inside of the house, we're looking at about 90 degrees, so roughly a 27 degree temperature differential, and there's no air conditioning on in the house at all. Obviously, we're finishing up drywall, so just some of the benefits of the way the house was built, framed, insulated, and air sealed.